So a couple weeks ago, Phil X calls me. He's like, "Hey, have you heard the new Nuno guitar solo?" I'm like, "No, no, no." He's like, "Oh, dude, you got to check it out. You got to check it out. You got to check it out and call me back." So, of course, I didn't because I was driving at the time. By the time I got home, I forgot to check it out. My brother John calls me. He's like, "You heard the new Nuno guitar solo?" I was like, "No, no, no." He's like, "Oh, I got to check this out." So finally, the next day, Phil texts me again. He's like, "Did you check the Nuno guitar solo out?" I said, "No, no, no. I'll check it out now." So I listened to it. I was like, "Oh, my God. It's unbelievable. Listen to the whole track." The track's called Rise. It's a new Extreme single. So yesterday, I was talking to Steve Lukather, and the solo came up. He's like, you hear the new Nuno guitar solo? He's like, "It's unbelievable. It's amazing. Oh, Nuno is the guy. He's just incredible." And, you know, I was thinking about this, that Nuno, for guitar players, everybody knows that Nuno is really kind of the guy now. Really, after Eddie, to guitar players, we really knew that he was something really unique. Chops, phrasing, just ripping right hand, everything about his playing, aggressive, play the whammy bar, did everything, just, you know, just rip your head right off. But because More Than Words was really their first big single, which was on Porno Graffiti, which is Extreme's second record, which came out in 1990, and the single actually came out, I want to say, like May 91, kind of pre-grunge, if you think about it. The Pumpkins came out then you had Metallica, the Black Album, you had Nirvana, Nevermind, Pearl Jam 10, all these big records. But More Than Words was massively big on MTV and a number one hit across the world. So for those of you that don't know More Than Words, that's Gary and Nuno singing, Gary the singer. So this is basically like a live recording of the two of them playing and singing. And you see Nuno there and he's like, "Oh, he's a ballad singer. They're a ballad band." Well, then they had another song on the record that was a single called Wholehearted. And everybody, that became a hit single too. That's this thing that was done with a 12 string. I'll play a little bit of this. Got a really cool funky groove with a 12 string. Great licks there. But there's a guitar solo in Get the Funk Out that is unbelievable. This is when everyone was like, "Wow." Wow. Great groove. Woo! I mean, honestly, other than Eddie, I had never heard anything like that. It was unbelievable. Everyone knew Nuno could play, and he's one of the best guitarists period. Best rock guitar players ever. Just incredibly great. Years have gone by. That was 1991. And so they come out with a new single a couple weeks ago. So the song's called Rise. I'm going to play the beginning of it here. Drop D. Great singing, too. Gary Cherone, awesome. Come along, come and join us. Beautiful harmonies. In the middle of the madness. Get your mind and your eye and your reason and roll. Then. You can feel it. Can you taste it? Take a bite of great vocal. Life, don't you waste it. Ride the lightning. Roll the thunder. You're the chosen one. I'm gonna lift you up. What I love about this. I love it when the chords change, when you have a static riff. So then you've got the, you know. Then it goes to the. Da 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 da. Then it goes into that riff there. And then. Back to the intro riff. Wow. That's really kind of like an Eddie dive bomb. As I'm listening to it the first time, I'm like, God, great vocals. Got a great chorus. Let me get to this guitar solo. Because I don't usually, you know, I'm listening in my car and stuff, so I'm not fast-forwarding or anything. I'm listening to the song. But eventually it gets to the guitar solo. So right before the solo, there's a little bridge. Rare. Ben. Right? Okay, all right, so right, whammy bar dive bomb down. But that super fast tremolo picking like Van Halen, amazing. Listen to that opening, it just storms out of the... Love the staccato guitars. Then cool. Then here. Wow. Okay, so the first half of the solo is just incredible. It's very, very, very Nuno. But with the Van Halen tremolo picking, I love this. This is really it's such an aggressive style, but it's very much like his Get the Funk Out aggressive style in that. That's really his own thing. And it's so digging in and aggressive in the note choices and everything. When you play those blues lifts, I mean, they're just blazing. But then you get to that, what I call false fingering part here, which is beautiful. This is the kind of stuff I like to do. I can't do it fast like. You can hear that there's a pattern to it. I was messing around trying to figure out what the pattern is here. I think I kind of have what it is. It's hard to play. And if you're trying to play along, don't practice it for too long because you're going to get tendonitis, because I think I just got tendonitis just by trying to play it slowly here. It's kind of a complex pattern, but once you get it, I think, which I don't have, I think you'll be able to play it fast if you practice it. I wear my guitar up so that I can do it. I'm wearing it up here so I can actually get those notes here. But the first part here goes from the 7th to the 12th fret. Now we're in drop D. So let me break down the lick because it's the same pattern. Once you have the pattern, you just have to know where the fret combinations are. Okay, so it goes, it's basically in the bottom three strings. Okay, so it's like, that's the first part of it. Now, it's kind of tricky. I think Nuno's alternate picking all of this. It looks like it on the video. He's alternate picking this. So, and he's palm muting it. I'm not going to palm mute it because it obscures the notes. But, and he has, I think, a little delay on it. Although the first part of it sounds like it's bone dry. Okay. But I think that he kicks in a delay to give it more of an atmospheric effect right in that spot. So it's over a D major chord. That's really like a D add 9 sound. So then it goes. That's kind of tricky there. That's the hardest part in there. Let me play it slow. One, two. Okay, so it does that lick three times. The third time it goes open D. And that's the hard part. So it goes. Okay, the hardest part of that is this 7th fret A to the false fingering of the 12th fret of the same note. So it's like. Let me do the whole ascending line in full. Then the descending line goes like this. Okay, that's the first part of it. You got to get that open D string in there. It's tricky. I stopped on those open strings, those open D and open A strings. The next section is the same pattern, but it's at the 7th and 10th frets. So it goes like this. I'll do it slow. And descending. The third one starts here, 5th fret to the 9th fret. Descending. And then the last one goes from the 8th fret to the 12th fret. And then descending. And that's the whole fast lick. Now I'm not going to try to play it up to tempo. But the great thing about it is how it works over the chords. Let me play it for you one more time here, the second part here. Listen. The bass goes. So it goes. So it has the third in the bass there. I love that. It's just like. Beautiful. And then it goes down to B minor. But it's really B minor 9. With a, he has a 9th in there. Listen. That's really like B flat major 7 sound. Really, really killer ending. One more time, let me play it for you. Second half right here. Wow. To me, that's a new bar right there. You know, there's a lot of great guitar players out there. You'll see them on Instagram. You'll see them everywhere. But they're usually not playing, or 99% of the time, almost 100% of the time, they're not playing as part of an actual song that's out there. That's the guitar solo that has its spot in the tune. This is like an old school thing that we just haven't heard in forever. And I hope to have Nuno here at some point to interview, because I want to ask him about this. And he's just, you know, unbelievable. He's the guy now, I think. So, love to know your thoughts. Leave a comment. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Really important. Thanks so much for watching.